Hey guys, welcome to the video. We're someplace we've never been before. You'll have to stick around after that intro to find out where we're at. Roll that intro.
Yeah, I just wanna see the light.
Guys, we are at Camp Cedar. It's a campground / glamping, as you can see. They have cabins and camp spots. We're here the week before everything opens, but when it's all the way open, they have pool, they have like food truck area, they have a restaurant. Certain cabins, like the one we're in, also come with a fire pit. So we'll show you that in a second when we go outside. But for now, let's jump into the tour. Okay, so we're going to start in the bathroom from our friend Bob from All About the Smokies. It's his favorite place to start, so I figured, what the heck? Throw it out to Bob here. So as you can see, right off the kitchen, the bathroom has a nice sink area. The towels are actually in this drawer. And they're soft clothes, as you can see. The nice potty. It's got a little towel rack right here. Nice actual shower. It's got like actual benches. There's two benches in there. And a nice shower head.
But no tub if you have a little one.
Yeah, and there's no tub if you have a little one in this one. See out the window here a little bit. Okay, so moving from the bathroom, we'll go to the master bedroom. There's Beth. So this is the one bedroom. This cabin that we're in is the Aspen, and it sleeps 8. So this is 2. It's a queen size bed. Kind of nice. The only thing is, it's only got like one nightstand, and then there's a plug on this side of the bed, but it's kind of like down there. There's a mini split in both in this room and in the front room for air conditioning and heat. So I was just over there in the bathroom. The closet's right here. There's actually like a little TV up here as well. This is the electrical panel. There's your controls for your AC right here on the wall. And then we'll finish off the bedrooms here. But look how steep this is. Look, there's Devin. He's way up there. So this one, it's kind of like a loft area. It's got like two, I would say these are the same size beds as downstairs, like queen size beds. Uh-huh. And it's got windows all around, as you can see. And there's also outlets, one there. Is there some behind the bed?
No.
No, none behind the bed, but they're just on the walls next to the bed, but there's plenty of outlets up here. Uh-huh. And a really cool feature of this is it has an overlook. There's Beth way down there. So this is overlooking the living area. We'll go down there in a second. It's so really, like over there is like a area to store your clothes and stuff or bags. So it's kind of neat. What's plugged in over there, Devin? Is it?
It's like just the fan.
Okay. So it's like a little fan that moves air from downstairs up here. Yeah, this is like super steep. It, I don't know if you can tell, but it's like straight down. They also have this nice, I guess it's like vinyl wood plank floor in here. It's kind of nice. There's where we just were with Devin. TV on the wall. Refrigerator. They do have like Airbnb style, so they do have silverware, cups, and plates. So that's kind of nice. They also have a phone right here where you can call the front desk, housekeeping, concierge. So this sleeps 8, so there's 2 in the bedroom, 4 upstairs, and then 2 on this pull-out couch. Right off the front door, there's a closet. It has the linens for the pull-out bed, like the pillows and the sheets. There's also a safe and a iron in there.
And a broom and dustpan.
Yeah, so if you make a mess, broom and dustpan. There's another air vent controller out here for the mini split that's in this room. So we also do have a dishwasher, a microwave, and a stove. So it's like a full kitchen, really. It's really nice. I mean, it even has like a coffee pot too.
And a toaster.
All right, the sun's actually coming out, so let's head outside, guys, and check that out. If you do go outside, just note that the door does lock, so take a key with you. I found that out the hard way. So we have deck chairs out here. This is kind of the community.
We're parked like right outside of our cabin. Oh, sorry for the wind. It's a little bit breezy today. But as you can see, this is the entrance. Nice little walkway up to it. There's a picnic table and a grill. And right here is a propane fire pit, which we're going to hopefully use for s'mores later, depending on the weather. Kind of like we're at the end of the area. So this is just loops back around to the front. As you can see over here, we'll take a drive down there, but there's campsites over here as well, along with more cabins over here.
Also, those little carts right there are for, you know, if you have a cabin down farther that's not accessible directly from the parking spot, you can put your stuff in it, and you can roll your stuff to your cabin.
Okay, so right next to us, they have like little pads right here, as you can see, for campers. So there's a really wide section for campers, and they all have the same, it looks like they all have power, water hookups as well, and some of them do have the propane fire pits. And it looks like they're kind of like constructing a road through here somewhere. Maybe it's going to connect to the King's Mill Road. You can tell this is a dog friendly area. We'll show you in a second, but they have the dog poop bags. So right here, if you bring your doggy, just remember to pick up the poop. But it's kind of nice that they have that. I did want to also point out that this is a campground, and they do have the cabins, but there's no tent camping allowed here. If you're going to park on a pad, you have to have an RV or a fifth wheel, something like that. And it's kind of cool. It looks like they're actually expanding, so you can see kind of down through here, they're expanding a little bit down that way, which is neat. Looks like they're putting more cabins in. So these are the smaller cabins up this way. They have 8 and 4 person cabins. So these look like they kind of have, some of them might have fire pits, but most of them just have grills, it looks like, doesn't it? Mm-hmm. That's a pretty far ways down, huh? Lots of cabins back there. Okay, looks like up here they have like a little recreation area for basketball. If you wanted to so partake in that, that'd be kind of fun. Not right now because it's kind of cold, but so there's the entrance sign. It's a luxury outdoor resort. I kind of agree with that statement. Now, if you do want to rent a golf cart, they do have golf carts available as well. Just note, the golf carts are $80 a day for your stay. So just, you know, if you make sure you have a need for it, I guess, is what I'm saying. Also, on this side of the building is where the shuttle will pick you up to take you to Kings Island. This is kind of the main lobby lodge area. You have ice, your sundries, snacks, and stuff like that. As well as the Ironwood Grill, which is kind of like it's their main signature restaurant here. It's not open currently. Actually, we're here the weekend before Kings Island opened, so everything's open next weekend. So this is kind of part of the pool area. And then out through here, which is really neat, which I wish they had opened, is kind of like a food truck area / dining area. And they have like little games, so you can kind of see the food trucks type things. They're quick service type meal things. They got like the shuffleboard, and I'm guessing this might be like either cornhole or horseshoe, but they have like those neat little popcorn lights in the middle there. It'd be really neat to actually see this open. Kind of back around Bully Street. Neat. I believe that there's the pool hall, and there's a fitness center right here. So I believe there's actually laundry in there as well. You can see some people are actually camping this weekend. Don't know if they're camping out for next week when Kings Island opens, but I guess any day is a good day to get out with the camper, huh? All right, so that kind of concludes a little tour of Camp Cedar. We'll wrap this up in the cabin.
All right, guys, hope you like this little quick tour. You know, as we do, we're going to spend the night tonight, let you know how the beds are if we had any problems or anything with the place, and then maybe we might throw some s'mores cooking in. I don't know how. Hopefully, it's a little bit windy and chilly, so we'll see. Right now, we're going to go try to find some dinner. There are restaurants really close, since we're really close to Kings Island. We're only like a mile and a half away from, or 1.1 miles away from Kings Island. And if you take the shuttle, you know, that's even better. So, all right, we'll see you guys in the morning.
Hey, guys. Welcome to the next morning.
Yeah, so we had to sleep on it to let you know how we thought, or what we thought of it. The Aspen and the Hickory, we're in the Aspen, are both 8-people cottages. The Sycamore, Mulberry, and Birch are all 4-person, so that means that some of them have a loft. The 2 out of the 3 just have the 3rd and 4th person is sleeping on the couch. So just wanted to let you know that. We did like the layout of this Aspen. It kind of provides a separation, but do you think 8 people could comfortably sleep in this?
I think if most of them were kids, you'd be fine. My problem is the fact that if you had 8 people in here, there's just the 1 small bathroom. They definitely don't give you enough like body wash and shampoo, I don't think, to last for 8 people. Plus, if you've got little ones, you know, the no tub might be a problem.
I think if it's 8 adults with the 1 bathroom, and there's like 3 chairs in here, it's gonna be tight.
Yeah, I think this space is definitely designed for you to spend most of your time outside.
Or at the park.
Just not in here.
Yeah.
I mean, they have plenty of room to like store and prepare food.
Oh yeah.
But they only have the 1 couch and 1 chair. There's no table and dining chairs inside. They do have a picnic table outside. So like I said, I really just think they expect you to spend most of your time outside. So if the weather's going to be iffy, you might have some problems with everybody being inside.
Yeah. So, I mean, it is what it is. We're here, obviously. We thought the second weekend of April would be warm, but we didn't end up doing the s'mores thing last night because it was windy and cold. And we just didn't want to, you know, deal with the fire pit thing with the wind, so.
And when we say cold, it was 33 degrees.
Yeah, we had a freeze warning last night, so.
We also want to mention the cancellation policy.
Yeah.
Because come Friday morning, we were, you know, kind of wondering, should we really do this since the weather's not going to be the greatest? But their cancellation policy really kind of sucks.
Yeah, like most hotels give you 24 hours. This is like you have to do 72 hours. And if you cancel within the 72-hour window, you're charged $50. So there's a $50, I guess, service fee, no matter what you pay, because you pay 1 full night's deposit when you book this. So we paid $150, for example, so we would have only got $100 back. If you cancel after the window, they don't refund your money at all. So if you were, something happened, or, you know, you had a medical emergency or something, you'd be just charged the full amount of 1 night. Not your full stay, but it would be the 1 night deposit. So just wanted to mention that. Just something to be aware of when you come here.
I did think the bedroom downstairs, what we, you know, consider the master bedroom, was a little on the tight side. The side of the bed that does not have the table, you have about 6 inches between the bed and the wall, which is not the easiest to get in and out of bed from. I found myself crawling out the end of the bed instead of going along the side. So, you know, just think about that when you're, you know, booking this cabin.
The bathroom was nice. The bedroom was tight. The mini split kind of, I don't know, I had some issues trying to get it to you. I guess it might not go to cool when it's too cold outside, but it was warm in the bedroom last night.
We ended up cracking, I'm used to sleeping with it cold.
We ended up cracking the window, so it wasn't too bad. Other than that, I can't think of really any negatives. I would definitely stay here again. Maybe check out another cabin. When everything's open, it would be kind of good to see, like, the pool, the food truck area. There's actually a walking path on the map that we didn't even check out, so.
And when we made the reservation, like, a month ago, we didn't know the restaurant and all those things would not be open.
Yeah.
We just found that out within the past week. Granted, we did get a good price on the room because we were staying here before Kings Island opened. But, you know, that comes with a lot of trade-offs.
Oh, speaking of that, I do want to mention that this place, since it is kind of, you know, bundled with Kings Island and everything, you can book Kings Island tickets, like day tickets, through your reservation. You can also do like a dining thing where you purchase like a breakfast. Because that's not included, even when the restaurant's open. So you'd have to pre-buy breakfast for an extra fee. So, you know, this place can get a little spendy. It's not like as, like, I don't think it'd be as economical as, say, a hotel room that's around the area. But you're paying for, like, the luxury of having the space, I think.
And the fact that they do have shuttles that run back and forth, I think, quite regularly to
yeah,
Kings Island.
Yeah, he said that as long as there's people out and about and taking them, then the shuttles are running. So they probably run open to close, and then probably a little bit after close, just to get everyone back that would be coming back here, so.
And there are plenty of restaurants in this area, both sit-down restaurants and fast food.
Yeah, there's tons. I mean, we had Dunkin' for breakfast, but there's like all kinds of fast food within like 3 to 5 minutes of drive from here. So don't worry about being just like eating just here if you don't want to pay, you know, what resort fees would be, you know, for captive audience, as I call it, for the food prices here. But I don't think that, honestly, we did like the pantry thing last night and it really wasn't that bad, I didn't think, you know, comparatively to...
In the shop where they have the check-in at, there's also a lot of, you know, camping supplies. There's also some quick snacks and drinks and that kind of thing. So we did pick up some snacks there last night, and the prices really weren't that bad. I think they were probably comparable with, like, gas station prices.
Yeah, I'd say gas station prices. I mean, it wasn't, like, overpriced, which kind of surprised me. Anyway, we're getting kind of long in the tooth here on this one, so you have any other thoughts?
I think that's it.
Okay, so, well, we enjoyed this making this video for you guys. We hope you guys enjoyed it as well. If you did, why don't you go ahead and smash that like button. If you're new here and you want to keep up with our travels, there should be more key travels in a short bit. Short bit. I can't give it away when. Go ahead and click that subscribe button. If you want to help support the channel, we do have a coffee page. It's kind of like a virtual tip jar. Buy us a coffee. We also have merch. The link should be down below this video in a merch tray. It should pop up on the screen too, maybe. That wraps us up. Thanks a lot for watching. Peace and love.